Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to my world. This is the world of Wayne and happy Friday. Today we're going to be doing the next four stages, that's 71 to 74 of the Fanhome release and build the Mark III Iron Man armor. Now, coming up to issue 71, we haven't really had much to do in each stage. We've done the arm, we've done the leg, we've done the body, but it's been small amounts in each pack. The next four stages, we do have quite a bit to do, and we are actually going to start piecing everything together. So this is what I love when everything starts coming together. Sounds like a quote from the A-Team, doesn't it? If you want to get this for yourself, I have put the link down here to the Fanhome website. You can get this all the way from pack one. But without further ado, let's get cracking. So as you can see, I have laid all of the little tiny bits all over the place because I don't know which bits I'm going to need next. But in stage 71, we are going to be doing central leg supports and the base. Now we've got all of this here, but we are going to need some parts that we had in stage 52 and stage 33, which are basically these two things here. So I've had to dig them out. That's why I put everything up here. And it looks like we're making some joints for the hip. And then we're going to be putting the base together. And that's everything we're doing in this stage. So this is everything in that pack. I'm glad I zoomed out that camera on the side there. We're not actually going to need the base section at the moment, so let me just leave that to one side. What I am going to need are the hip joints and the L screws that I've got here. So quite simply, all I'm going to do is I'm going to take one of these ball joints here. I'm going to put that through the top so it's coming out the bottom just like that. And then this is going to be attached to the other side of this hip joint here. It's just going to go in there like that, and it's held in with LP screws. Definitely the screw of choice on this build, because everything that we're doing in this stage takes LP screws. That's why they've gave us so many of them. Now, as you can see at the moment, the little bracket that we've got at the top there is not actually fixed to anything, so that's free to just go around at the moment. We're going to do the same on the other side again, putting this through, should be that way. And then again, putting this on here, holding it together with L screws. So as you can see, we now have two of these, and we can put them to one side. And I'm guessing that the next part's probably gonna be best on the side camera because this is so big, but we are gonna assemble this base here. And basically, this is what the base looks like. Gonna put these two parts aside. Now there are different bases. If you've got the premium set for this, you will get a different base, but I haven't got that. This is the standard base which comes with this. Now we've got these two little tabs here which are gonna just go down the sides here just to hold these together while I'm putting these in. So one this side and one that side. So that can't part now, but then I've got these little T-shaped brackets which are going to go into the center of all of these points here. And this is what's going to hold everything together. So two LP screws on each one. And there you go. That's all of them in place. That's what the base looks like. Quite big, as you can see. Not going to need that for the minute though. So now I can put that to one side, but that's the end of that stage. That leads us swiftly on to stage 72. If I just turn to that section here, we're going to be doing the chest and the base. So we've got quite a few bits here which are going together. I thought we were finished with a base, but it looks like we've actually got the rod, which is going to be the support mast for this figurine. We don't actually need the base though. Not quite sure what we're actually doing in this, but let's get this open and have a look. It's worth saying in the last stage, we did have this part left over. We're not using that at the moment, so I can just put that to one side. This absolutely ginormous section here, and believe me, it's not only ginormous, it's heavy. I'm guessing this is all metal. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to turn this upside down, and we've got this arc reactor casing here. That's going to go on the inside around this way here. Just like that. We want to make sure that these little sections here are over the screw holes just here and here. We're going to be securing that in with some EM screws. Again, I'm going into metal here. So I have put these in some oil. It will just cut those screws and make them go in nice and smoothly, just like that. Let's do the second one. So when that's in, that should look like that from that side, and from the front, it looks like that. Okay, so the next book we've got is actually a little switch, believe it or not. It's a little button for the switch. What we're going to do is put this end through this side like this. And what this is going to do, the flat end here is going to engage the button on the arc reactor to turn it on and off. Now the arc reactor is going into this cavity here, which means this is going on top. It's held in with IP screws. I've got one here. So one that side, just put one in the other side. There we go, there's the one in the other side. So as you can see, what's going to happen is we'll push that in from the back, and then that's going to activate the button just there. We're not actually mounting the arc reactor. As a matter of fact, we can put that to one side. And the last thing I'm going to do is put these masks together, and these are solid metal as well. Pretty impressive. So quite simply, we've got two little screw holes on this side. We're just going to be putting these together just like this. So that the holes in this point here, just going to line up with the holes there. Just going to rotate it round so I've got these completely where they need to go. There we go. It only slots in one way, so keep turning it and it'll go in. And that's going to be held in just with 72G, which is actually a couple of pins. Now, just looking at these pins, you have got a beveled edge. So it's that edge that's going to want to go in first. So put them on there. Get me hammer. Just hammer this into place. Just like that. Put another one in next to it. That's them in. So we've got one solid piece of metal now, and that's all there is to do in that stage. Now before we actually finish, around this section here, they're calling this, I love it when they do this, they're calling this an adjustment sticker to make it secure into the base a lot easier. So the sticker that we've known before as just adhesive tape is now a calibration adjustment sticker, and I can't get it off. I can now. This is just going to go around this section of the base here. I'm guessing it's going to make it fit a lot easier onto the base because it is a calibration sticker. We only need one of these. I'm putting that all the way around. And there we go. It's going to fit more flush into the base now. But that's all there is to do in that stage. So in stage 73, as you can see here, we've got the chest and the base. We've got more bits that we're going to be putting together on the chest and putting these together. And we're finishing off by actually attaching the rod to the base. We've got some more sort of like foam sticker here. Lots of screws. Let's get this open. And the first parts we need are these two sections here. And quite simply, what we're going to do is we're just going to be putting these onto this plate here. So one, oops, other way around, one in this side. Get both of these in and show you what that looks like. And then just one on the other side. But they are going to be held in from the other side with IP screws. So get the first one in. I think I had them round the wrong way then, but at least I've got them in before I started to screw in the right way. So two for this one. So that looks like that, and I'll just put the other one in position as well. We bring over this part, which comes in this stage, because we're going to be joining these two parts together. Quite simply, this is just going to go onto the front of this section just like that. Turn it over, and once again, in two holes here, held in with IP screws. One this side. I'm not going to make that too tight until I've got the other side in. And one the other side. So that looks just like that. Bring over the chest piece again. And this is going to be going onto this top section here, fitting into place like that. Turn it over, and then once again, held in with two IP screws just down the bottom here. So that's in, and now that looks just like that. Put that to one side because we're going to be working some more on the upright mast. And this is where we need one of these adhesive supportive strips here. And we're going to want to put this on the inside of this section here. So I'll just start this off. Make sure it's quite neat in there. Not quite neat, very neat. This is where my OCD will start playing up. But no, we've got that perfectly straight in there like that. This is to protect the figurine when it's actually standing in the mast, I'm guessing. We want to take this section here, and we've got a spring. I need to put the spring inside, which is going to go in just like that. I'll get a GM screw ready because I'm about to put these two bits together. And as you can see in this section, we've got an indent. We want to put that indent over where the spring is so it fits flat. Just like that. Then sort of, it's now got that give in there, as you can see. So get this flange GM screw into the top to keep that into place. Looks like a claw. And there we go. As you can see, that now has a spring-loaded section like that. Bring over the mast, and I'm going to attach this to two points on the mast. I'm just seeing where they've got it in the magazine. They've got it on the third and fourth one down. So these two just here. Just seeing if it goes better in each way. That's one way. Let's just try it the other way. I think it actually goes better in that way. And then that's held in with KM screws. Bit of oil, quite long these screws. Get that in. Make that nice and tight. That's the second one, and then all there's left to do, as you can see, that's quite solid. Let's put this in the base. So I've got the base here, and there we go, that's in just like that. Perfect. Looks like the old what do they used to call them, tripods? I don't know. Remember in school, the L-shaped stands, L stands? I don't know. But that's all there is to do in that stage. So the last stage here, stage 74. We're just going to be doing a bit more of the chest here. It's only one piece by the look of it that's going to go into what we've just worked on there. So this is actually a very short stage. Perhaps they thought we've been a bit spoilt and we need to just calm it down a bit and bring it back to just having one thing to do. I do take the mic, don't I? Okay, so quite simply, all we're going to do is this is just going to go onto the front, just putting it into position like this. I've pushed that in, and it's held in from the other side. This is what it's looking like with IP screws. They come in this. We need four of these, and then just at these points here as well. And then we just do his opposites on the other side. And there you go. When that's all in, it should look like that. And that's all there is to do in that stage. So there you go. That's another pack completed. Loads to do in that pack. Obviously done the base, and we've started to do the metal chest as well, which is looking really good. If you want to get this for yourself, I have put the link down in the video description. You can get this all the way from pack one, but I really do hope you like that video. If you did, please remember to give me a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed already, please remember to subscribe. Other than that, take care. You